Hey guys, it's Mike. Today, Chipper and I are gonna be sharing with you 4 to 5 Windows tips and tricks that are gonna allow you to become more organized, more efficient, and just overall allow you to get more work done in less time. I am MK the CPA, and along with my sidekick Chipper, we teach people personal finances, investing, taxes, and more. And as you guys know, normally I make videos geared around personal finances and taxes. However, in today's video, I'm gonna be sharing with you some life and career tips, things that I do and use using Microsoft Windows to be more organized and more efficient. I use these things on a daily basis, and I'm excited to share these things with you guys. So let's get started. Now, nothing I'm going to show you guys is magical. In fact, you might already know most of this stuff, but maybe you're not using these features to your advantage. Okay guys, the tips we're gonna be talking about today are gonna be specifically focused around organization. If we are unorganized and things are cluttered, studies have shown we can easily waste 4 to 5 hours every single week just looking for stuff. In a 40-hour work week, that's roughly 10% of your time right there. So we're gonna look at helping you eliminate that. Now the first tip was we're gonna start with the Windows desktop and getting yourself uncluttered. Okay guys, the first tip is really an obvious one, but it's really to clean up your desktop. And I really encourage, this is our desktop right here, and I would really encourage you to use that as much as possible because whatever's on your desktop is right there in front of you. You don't have to go digging further into the file directories of Windows, etc. It's right here, all for you to access. Now the mistake I see many people make, and I used to do this myself to be honest, is leave this a mess. We wanna clean this up as soon as possible. And a lot of this stuff, now in this case, I'm gonna delete all of this, but let's say you had files you didn't know what to do with or whether or not you should delete them. Well, what you can do is, or what I do is I like to create a folder called stuff to go through. So what I would do is I would highlight all of this right here. If I didn't want to delete it and I wasn't sure what to do with it, I would then drag it to this stuff to go through folder. And now look how clean this desktop is. It's almost too clean. Now you can just focus on your task at hand, and that overwhelming amount of files is out of your face, but it's all still right here if you need it. And now let's talk about how do we get easy access to our programs that we want to use the most. And to do that, we use pin to start menu and pin the taskbar. Now our taskbar is right here. And I believe there is a limited number, I'm not 100% sure, but I believe there's a limited number of items you can pin down here. Correct me if I'm wrong, please let me know if you can pin more, I would love to know. But the other area is if you wanna pin to the start menu, this is your Windows start menu. I'm on Windows 10 as you guys can see, but I believe this should work for Windows XP and above. But let's say there's a program that you wanna use a lot, and this can be any program on your computer, whether it's at home or at work. And this, let's say we want to use Audacity a lot. When for my videos that I produce, I do use Audacity quite a bit. And so it's probably a program that I would use frequently enough that I'd want to put it along this taskbar so I can get it quickly. And the way to do that is I would just right click and I would find under more, pin the taskbar. Now this program is on my taskbar right here. And you can also use pin to start menu. So let's say I wanted to use Diablo. Let's say Diablo 3, which is a game I have. I wanted to use this a lot, and I wanted it to show up in the start menu whenever I opened it. What you can do is I can do right click, and I would do pin to start. And boom, there it is right here. So now I can move this up. And so now, whenever I go back to my start menu, it's right there. Look how quick I was able to access that. So think about the software programs you use the most and that you wanna have the access to the easiest and put them along here, or put them right here in your start menu and it will save you a ton of time, I promise. Check it out. Okay guys, tip number three is to really make the time to get organized because it is so worth your time. Now I have a series of folders that I've organized with YouTube, but let's pretend I wasn't organized at all, and let's pretend I had to go there from scratch. And let me just show you how long this takes. So to get there, I'd have to go to Start menu. I would click on this PC, and then I would click on Volume D because I know it's there. And then I would go to Backup to Cyber PC because that's where I've stored all this stuff. And finally down here I have YouTube, but I'm still not at the videos I want. So now I have to go to Videos Created by Me, and now I'm finally here. Now can you, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So almost 7 folders I had to go through to get to this point. Can you imagine how often or how much time this would take me if I didn't know exactly where that was? Well, the thing to do is to make the time to create desktop shortcuts. So instead of me going through all these file paths, what I should have done is now that I've found this main folder, and you have to find the main directory to this folder, if I just want to get to my videos faster, I can create a desktop shortcut. So what I'll do is I would right click and then go down here to see where it says send to. See how it says desktop create shortcut? So what it's gonna do is it's gonna create a shortcut directly to that file. And boom, so there it is right there. So now watch. So now instead of going through 7 steps to see all my videos, now all I have to do is click this and I'm instantly there. And you can do that for each of these folders. You know, you can make shortcuts for anything really. And what I would recommend doing is to take this one step further and create a folder, you know, something that makes sense to you. And let's say you wanted to have all of your YouTube shortcuts, anything related to YouTube. Well, you can put a YouTube folder right here, and then, or you can, like, I'm gonna call it YouTube in this case. I'm gonna move my shortcuts to here, and then I can do a shortcut to anything I want that's related to my YouTube channel and information and files all in one folder. And it looks so nice and neat because now my desktop is still clean, it's still uncluttered, but I can just access all this information very quickly. So make the time to create these desktop shortcuts. I can't begin to describe how much time this simple little trick will do you by just taking a few seconds to create shortcuts with the stuff you use the most. Okay guys, ready for tip number 4? And then I'll still keep watching because then I'll show, I saved the best tip for last that most people do not know about and I learned recently and it is so powerful. So let me show you, I think this is a Windows 10 feature, but you can actually, instead of, we talked about pinning the taskbar and we talked about pinning the start menu, but in Windows 10, correct me if I'm wrong guys, but I think this is only Windows 10. There's a thing called quick access. So if you have Windows 10, you can actually pin stuff to this quick access bar. Now, this quick access bar is always gonna show up whenever you open a folder. You can open up any folder of any kind and see how it's there. Watch, I'll go back to the YouTube folder I just made and it's there too. So basically, whatever you want to pin along here, you can. So like if I want to go to the main YouTube folder or the main YouTube file directory, and I want to say, okay, my laptop music is really important to me and I want to make sure I can access anytime, what I would do is I would right click on laptop music and then do pin to quick access. And bam, there it is, it's number one. You can arrange these in whatever order you wanted. So if you wanted this to be to the very top, even above your desktop, you could. You can move it back down here. It's like wherever you want to move it, wherever, what makes sense to you. Whoops, I guess I gotta pull this one up. There we go. So I guess you can't pull it down that way. But you guys get the idea. Is it's really easy to pin stuff to this quick access menu. And this will save you time whenever you open up a folder. The stuff you need will be right there. Okay. Okay, guys, I have saved the best for last, and it deals with using hotkeys to get to things even faster. And hotkeys will work for program file shortcuts and also actual shortcuts to folders. And a shortcut is something we were looking at just a few minutes ago, but see this little arrow right here on this folder? That little arrow indicates it's a shortcut. And the same is true for program files. So if you have a little arrow next to the program, it means the shortcut path to that program. So what I'm going to show you guys is how you can set hotkeys to access these folders instantly just by using a quick touch of your keyboard. So let's say Microsoft Office Excel. Microsoft Excel is a program people use all the time, especially at work. So let's find this. So I go to my start menu and I already have Microsoft Excel pinned here. I'm going to show you guys how to do this. But what I would do is I would right click to get to it, and I would go to more, and I would go to open file location. Obviously, if you go to my PC and go down through the file directories, you can find it the same way, but this is a quicker way for me to find it. So I'm gonna go to open file location. And now, as you can see, it takes us to this Microsoft Office folder. And if you look here, see, no, I'm using Microsoft 2007 on my personal computer. Don't judge me. Because it's free. But see this little shortcut arrow right here? As long as there's a shortcut arrow, this will work. If there's not a shortcut arrow, it's not gonna work. But if you don't have a shortcut arrow, just do, you know, right click, send to desktop, create shortcut, and then that's how you can get that shortcut arrow. Now here's what's cool. So let's say you wanna make this a hotkey command so that this program will open instantly. So what you wanna do is you're gonna right click, go down to properties. Now, see where it says shortcut up here? Then this first page it opens, this first tab. See where it says shortcut key? See how it says none? Well, right now there's no programmed shortcut for this file, but we can change that. So just click your mouse cursor here, and I'm gonna do Alt F12 as my shortcut key. Alt F12. And now I'm gonna hit apply, and it says I need administrator privileges, so I'm the administrator, so I'm gonna click OK. And now I've hit applied, now I'm just gonna hit OK. Now watch, guys. This is freaking sweet. So now I'm hitting Alt F12 on my keyboard. 1, 2, 3. Boom! Instantly, I am right to this program. I don't even have to use my mouse now, as long as I've remembered what hotkeys I've set it to. And the same is true for your shortcut folders. If you go to any of these shortcut folders, like earlier we were looking at this video one, see where it says, if I right click on this and I go down to properties, same thing. I can make a shortcut key here. So I'm gonna do Alt F11. I'm gonna hit apply. I'm gonna get out of it. And now watch this, 1, 2, 3, Alt F11. Boom, I'm right to my photos and clips, or I guess I selected this one, but I'm right to it. This is gonna save you guys so much time. I can't tell you how many minutes this saves me of all the clicking around I used to do and whatnot. By using these 5 tricks, I know these are all basic, really newbie stuff, really, but if you use this to your advantage all in unison, you will save not only minutes, but those minutes you save will add up to hours and days over the course of your life and in your work and in your personal life. Hey guys, I really hope you got a lot out of those 5 tips. I know they're all very basic, but if you just make the time to get organized, create desktop shortcuts, clean up your desktop, organize your folders accordingly, and pin your most used programs to your taskbar, your start menu, and even the folders themselves, and use hotkeys all in unison, you are gonna be a time-saving machine. And the thing I didn't mention about, not only are you guys gonna be more efficient at work, more productive, but it's gonna help you communicate better at work. And the reason that is because when somebody asks for something from you, you're gonna be so quick to respond to them because your files are gonna be very organized and you're gonna know right where to go to find what you need. They're gonna look back at you and say, "He's really got his shit together." My question of the week is, what do you guys do to stay organized at work with your computer files on using Windows? Is there anything that I didn't mention that you feel I should have? Or what other tricks or tips that you might have? please share those in the comment section down below. And also in the description down below, I'm going to be including some links to some articles that would be that are related to this video. So make sure to check them out. All right, guys, drop a like, leave a comment or question down below. Make sure to subscribe if you have not already. Let me know if you would like to see more videos like this. I had a lot of fun making this one. I love making tutorial types of videos for you guys. And don't forget, you can also follow me on Twitter and on Facebook. But until next time, and most importantly, please take this information you learned here today and use it in your life. Apply it to your life so you can work more towards living your life uncaged. See you guys. Love you. I will see you in next week's video. Take care. Bye.